Assalamu alaikum. My name is Rabia Sad. I am a student of 4th prof. My roll number is EP1770119. The topic which I explain here is osteoporosis. As osteoporosis, it is a disorder of the bone. It is defined as a decrease in the bone strength. The strength of the bone, it depends on the mineral density and the bone quality. In osteoporosis, the bone physiology is that there is a decrease in the osteoblast formation and increase in the osteoclast formation. As the osteoclast, these are the regular shaped joint cells that break down or reabsorb the bone, whereas the osteoblast, these are the cells that are responsible for a new bone formation. So in osteoporosis, it has bone mineralization but abnormal osteoclast function, which ultimately decrease the bone strength and the bone mass, and it will predict the future risk. As the osteoporosis, it will affect 45% of the women aged 50 or the older. So osteoporotic bone is at the risk of fracture at the hip, wrist and spine. And if the fracture of the vertebral spine occur, then the patient will have a 5-fold increased risk for having a second vertebral fracture or the hip fracture. And the second vertebral fracture means that you have a more compression fractures in the future. With one hip fracture, there will be 10-fold increase of the another hip fracture occurring. Men with the hip fracture having a higher mortality rate than the women. Now, the current osteoporotic definition is that the bone mineral density, it is measured by the T-score. In normal bone, the mineral density is less than 1. In osteopenia, it is in between 1 to 2.5, wherein in osteoporosis, the BND, it is less than 2.5. Now, moving to attribution of causes. As it has no known definite cause, but many contribution factors will lead to this disorder, like negative calcium balance, impaired gonadal and the adrenal function, estrogen deficiency or the lifestyle. So we will have to work up on this in order to prevent the osteoporosis. Now moving to its type, it is divided into primary and secondary. And in primary type 1, the post-menopausal woman, osteoporosis, it occur within 15 to 20 years after the menopause, and it affect the trabecular bone and increase the risk of vertebral and wrist fracture, and it is usually due to an estrogen deficiency. Whereas in type 2 senile osteoporosis, it occur in women and men over the age of 70 years. It will affect the cortical and trabecular bone equality. It will affect the vertebral and hip fracture, and it occur more in female than the males, and it is due to an aging and long-term calcium deficiency. With aging, the inner bone diameter increases while the cortical thickness of the bone decreases. Whereas in secondary osteoporosis, it is caused by the prolonged use of medication like the glucocorticoids or some another diseases or the condition which will inhibit the absorption of calcium and therefore prevent the body's ability to produce the bones. Types of secondary osteoporosis. As secondary disorder, it can play an important role in the development of osteoporosis, and this will include having a high thyroid hormone level, parathyroid hormone level and the cortisol level, and these conditions will interfere with the bone remodeling. As in the parathyroidism, which is caused by the too much parathyroid hormone and can cause the osteoporosis because excessive hormone extract the calcium from your body. So overall production of the thyroid hormone may lead to bone loss. Whereas in hypogonadism in adults is a well acknowledged cause of the overall bone loss and the contributor to development of the secondary osteoporosis. And the hypercortisolism, also called the crushing syndromes, it will lead to osteoporosis as excessive endogenous glucocorticoids increases the bone reabsorption and decrease the bone formation, and it will cause a fracture up to 70% even in the presence of normal gonadal state and in the males. Whereas the gastrointestinal disease, this will also often associated with the development of secondary osteoporosis. like the nutritional deficiency caused by the malabsorption and the chronic malnutrition. That is, the people are unable to absorb the nutrient from the diet, or when the person dies does not provide the enough nutrient or the right balance. Or like systemic inflammation, like chronic inflammatory bowel disease, and the use of glucocorticoids. These are the risk factor for the secondary osteoporosis. Now, the osteoporosis in women, as we know that the women, these are the more risk factor. These are the more at risk of developing the osteoporosis than men, because at the menopause stage, their hormonal changes and it will affect the bone density. Also, the removal of the ovaries or the absent of period for more than 6 months due to an overexercise or overeating and the low level of estrogen, these may all lead to disorder. In osteoporosis in men, it is usually due to cause by the certain lifestyle behaviors, some use of medications like the glucocorticoids or some other diseases, like a low level of testosterone, alcoholic abuse, use of alcohol, smoking, gastrointestinal diseases, hyperkalemia, and the immobilization. These will all lead to osteoporosis in women, in men. Now moving to the case study. A 64 year old retired firefighter complaining his back pain, and which will be worse than usual in the past 3 weeks, and he is not on any medications. Prior, he is a smoker. His height is about 180 centimeter, weight is about 80 kg, and patients complain his back pain, which will become worse in the past 3 weeks. And body BMI, it is about 24.7 kg per meter. Now, it's objective that chances in height and weight can be sign of the vertebral fractures. This may be one cause, or the another cause is when physical examination is done, there is a rib pelvis distance and the occiput wall distance. So when we assess the patient, there is no history of the systemic glucocorticoids or the androgen deprivation therapy, no history of the secondary causes of osteoporosis, no previous trauma, but he is an alcoholic user, that is approximately 2 drinks per week. So we have to plan to treat their vertebral fractures. First line of treatment should be given, that is bisphosphonate, includes the risendronate, zoledronic acid, calcium supplements should also be given in the dose of 1200 per day. And for the back pain, NSAIDs like ibuprofen, it will be given for the relief of the back pain as per required. Thank you.